Hi guys, today I'll be taking a look at the phone book from anywhere. This is a Kickstarter project which I backed in November of 2019. The phone book is basically an external laptop stand to which you can connect your phone and use it as an external monitor, keyboard, and it has a trackpad. We'll be taking a look at the phone book itself and I'll be connecting it to my iPad. We'll start by opening the box. The package was sent by UPS and it took a few weeks in order to get to my country. This campaign in all has had a serious delay, which is partly due to the coronavirus, but also due to poor communication by the project creator, which said that all packages were already shipped end June, while it's today August the 1st. And the package was only shipped last week. In the box, we will get a smaller box, as well as the additional accessories which I had ordered when backing the project. These were the stretch goals that were unlocked. Most of them were for free, and I believe the carrying case was around $10. So we have a carrying case and a stylus included as well. Let's put these away. We'll start by unboxing the phone book itself. So the phone book is shipped in a decently well packaged box, which can be opened quite easily from what it seems. Ah, we also have the adjustable desktop stand. That was also one of the stretch goals of the project. We have the European power adapter, which is included. And we have the phone book. So it's basically just this brown box. No fancy packaging at all, as seen by some other guys who unboxed it earlier, a few months ago. But it's at least decently packaged, so that should be more than enough. One thing to notice is that there's no manual included. This has fairly often posted in the comments, so it will not be as easy for everyone to get this thing up and running. So we'll see if I'm succeeding in this video to set it up in one take. Here it is. It's reminding me a bit of MacBook Pro. It looks like it's out of aluminium, but the bottom is made out of plastic. It has some cooling fans. This is probably the internal battery. All in all, it looks really nice. It's got a nice metallic feel to it. It has a USB and a headphone jack. Nothing on the back. HDMI in for using it as an external PC monitor. USB Type-C for connecting Android smartphones and regular USB for connecting iOS devices, as well as a circular power plug for charging the internal batteries. On the bottom we have two tiny speakers for the sound, and inside we'll have a keyboard and a nice large trackpad. As we can see, it looks really nice. We have some light coming from the back, so I'll be closing the shutters of the window and then we continue setting up the phone book. Now that we don't have the sun shining on the screen, let's start by removing the built-in screen protector and let's try connecting my iPad to it. So we peel this plastic off. It's not intended to be used. It's not intended that you use this on the screen, as seen by the brown tab. We'll try turning it on. Let's see if they have charged it for me, or that we need to connect it to the charger first. I don't see anything happening, so my guess is Oh wait, it's starting up. I need to press the button a bit longer. It shows Anywhere logo. It looks nice, the screen. Ah, there it is. It's almost drained battery, as we can see. It's now telling us how we can connect the phone to the device. It's showing iOS mode, which is perfectly fine as I'll be using iOS devices only for now. And we need to connect the phone to the device, scan the QR code to download the Anywhere app, which I think I've already installed, but we'll try it anyway. And then in the app, we have to pair the Bluetooth to the device. So we are going to connect the iPad to the phone book with the original lightning cable from Apple. And then it should start showing the iPad screen on the phone book. Let's see if this works. Yes, that's in. I need to unlock the iPad to use accessories. Trust the computer. Yes, I want to trust this computer. And it's already starting to mirror. So that seems to be working fine. It's now showing the screen of the iPad on the phone book. Screen looks decently. It's a bit washed out here. Maybe we can try to change some of the settings. We still have to download the Anywhere app. Let's see if that's already on here. Oh yeah, it's already on. So we'll be using the Anywhere app to start fully using the iPad. It's now asking if we want to connect the Anywhere Bluetooth. This is the Bluetooth connection which you need to use for the keyboard and the trackpad. So once we connect the Bluetooth for the keyboard and the trackpad, it will allow us to type and use the trackpad to control the iPad. So it's now pairing with the keyboard in iOS mode. It shows key testing. And we have cursor, so we can start using the keyboard probably. It's showing some of my apps, Call of Duty, but Minecraft I don't have. So it's basically showing a few apps which they recommend to play on this phone book. Let's see if this allows us to change the orientation, I guess. Okay, I cannot click on here. Try if I tap on it. It will then rotate the screen. So let's see what we can do. I'm not sure if we can click already with the iPad or not, because I read there was some bug with iOS 13.4. And this iPad is running 13.5, I believe. So it might be affected with, it's 13.4.1. So it might be affected with the clicking bug. And the Anywhere company says that they will be going to fix this in the future. I'm not really sure if they will do, because they already promised a lot of things with the shipping, which they didn't initially deliver on. But hey, we got the product anyway after a while, so maybe they'll also update the phone book in order to fix the clicking issues with iOS devices. As for the keyboard, we should be able to use the keyboard. So we can use the keyboard of the phone book correctly. It allows us to type on the keyboard of the iPad. So that's at least a feature which is working properly. So if we are going to Google, we can just type in here and it will directly navigate. So that's working. I'm not really sure if we can. Is this touchscreen? No, it's not a touchscreen, I think. Or is it? No, it's not a touchscreen. So we have a mouse indicator here. I'm not really sure how this works. Function keys, LCD, volume. I don't think you can use the volume keys here, because the Bluetooth for the audio is also still a bug that you cannot use the speakers while using a phone. You can use the speakers if you use an HDMI, such as for a game console or a laptop. But from what I've read in all the comments is that you cannot currently use the Bluetooth for the audio of the iPad or your phone. So right now it's quite limited. If the scrolling and the clicking issues are fixed, then we'll be able to at least navigate the iPad properly. And if the sound issue are also fixed, then we can also enjoy a more quality of sound than using the iPad's built-in speaker. So I think that's it for the phonebook unboxing. I'll be using the phonebook for a bit more outside of the camera to see how it's working. Stay tuned for an update where I'll also try to use my old Android phone to see if we can use more features with an Android phone on this. And I will also be connecting my iPhone to see how that's working with the phonebook. Bye!